So as you know, mga kababayan, nagkakagulo ngayon sa Amerika after ng assassination attempt kay Donald Trump. Yung suspected assassin, based sa mga developments po ngayon, sabi may dalawang patay. And this time, mga kababayan, nagpalabas na ng kanyang statement si Joe Biden at nanawagan siya for unity. Siyempre, yung mga tao sa buong mundo, kanya-kanya pong speculations, just like yung nangyari po dito sa ating bansa, nang i-assassinate po si Ninoy Aquino, ang itino. Pero agad-agad si dating Pangulong Ferdinand Idralin Marcos. Dito po, siyempre, yun ang nasa isip ng mga tao. Kasi sila yung magpit na magkatunggali po. Pero hindi natin masabi, baka may other party, mga kababayan, na nag-take advantage ng sitwasyon.
So ito ngayon yung latest development, mga kababayan. Sabi sa report ng Inquirer, Biden calls for unity after Trump rally shooting. Pero si Trump po ay okay naman po. Trump is fine after shooting at rally campaign. At rally campaign says, prosecutor says gunman in one attendee are dead.
So dalawa yung patay, mga kababayan. Isa yung sabi, yung shooter mismo. Sunod-sunod yung pagpaputok po, mga kababayan. Kaya total chaos yung nangyari doon sa stage. At may isang attendee sa meeting, sa rally ni Trump, ang sabi, patay din. And possibly may mga injured po because of this stampede, yung commotion po.
So, ito yung image ng pinagtutulungan na si Trump na dalhin papunta sa kanyang sasakyan. Nakataas pa rin yung kanyang kamay. So, sabi dyan, Republican presidential candidate, former President Donald Trump is surrounded by U.S. Secret Service agent as a campaign rally at the campaign rally Saturday, July 13. So ito yung moment, mga kababayan, nang mangyari yung assassination attempt kay Donald Trump.
That just happened when the former president was speaking at his rally. Let's watch that video.
CNN report po. Yan po. Yan ang kaguluhan po.
Okay. So what you are watching is video from just a few moments ago when former President Donald Trump was on stage at his rally in Butler, Pennsylvania. You see the Secret Service who were surrounding him. You see how they got him to the ground after we heard those noises. We don't know what those...
Tapos tinaas pa ni Donald Trump, mga kababayan, yung kamay niya. Nandyan pa si Trump, mga kababayan. Nakakover siya. Protected by the U.S. agents.
At that rally site in Butler, Pennsylvania.
Ayan po. Let me get my shoes, Anya. Sinabi pa niya. Yan, kinover siya ng secret agents ng Amerika, U.S. secret agents.
What his status is, but you see him.
Tapos tinas pa niya yung kamay niya, oh.
And you see him doing
rallying his supporters. Tapos dinala na pababa sa sa kanyang sasakyan.
As the former president is led off the stage.
Yan.
In Butler, Pennsylvania.
Papuntang sasakyan niya. Yan yung sasakyan. Injured po siya. Tingnan niyo, duguan si Trump. Pero nakatikom ang kanyang kanyang kamoo, mga kababayan. Yan po si Donald Trump.
Hindi siya nawala ng loob. Hindi natakot si Trump. Hinawakan lang niya dito sa kanyang may parting batok. Parang dito yung tama niya sa may tainga, mga kababayan.
Sabi dito sa mga balita, suspected shooter at Trump rally dead. Yan po. Pero okay naman po si Trump. Sabi dyan, Trump is fine, campaign says, after being whisked off stage following apparent gunfire at rally. So ito yung moment, mga kababayan. Ulitin natin, mas maganda to.
All that chart, that chart's a couple of months old, and if you want to really see something to say
sa inyo, yung full story ng balitang yan, click subscribe mo na dito sa ating YouTube channel and hit the notification bell para lagi po kayong updated sa mga kaganapan dito sa ating bansa. Like and share na rin po ninyo ang ating video. At huwag na rin po ninyo na skip yung ating mga commercial ads para tuloy-tuloy lang ang pag-unlad ng Bagong Pilipinas. Sa mga nagana po ng Malinis and Spaces Fitness Gym, pumunta lang po kayo sa aming Colossal Fitness Gym. We also offer grab car rental with our brand new 2023 model ng Toyota Innova. We also accept booking for those who are planning to travel via PAL, Cebu Pacific, and other airline companies, local and international, and bills payment for Meralco bills, Aleco bills, PLDT, etc. Ang Colossal Fitness Gym is located at 3rd floor Security Bank Building, Lanco Business Park, Legazpi City, Albay. For inquiries, look for Jilon Maravillas, contact number 0966-802-0949. Yan po yung aming Innova. Lagi na pong matao sa amin. Yan po mga bagong clients namin. Napakaganda at colorful at napakalinis ng aming gym po. Pati mga foreigners po pumupunta sa amin. Mga British tourist po sila dito sa Legazpi. Na-set up na rin po yung aming mga brand new gym equipment. May treadmill na rin po kami. Ito naman po yung bago naming product na binibenta online. Eye Glow Serum, whitening po siya. Tingnan ninyo yung epekto sa aking anak na architect before and now. Yung mga inquiries po ninyo, dumiretso na lang kayo sa kanyang Facebook account, Riz Maravillas. Ito naman po, Firmax Firming and Lifting Cream, pinapahid po sa mga pulses in affected area. Mahinan po sa paninigas ng mga kasukasuan. Ito naman po, Automax Radiant Serum. Sa mukha naman yung application, anti-aging po siya. You will look 10 years younger than your age. Sa mga cancer patients naman po, baka lang gusto ninyo itong itry. Naing siya Red Mix Food Drink. Hindi mo po siya gamot, food supplement siya. Kaya lang, gawa siya mga kababayan sa Goji Berry. Yung Goji Berry, may anti-cancer properties. O ngayon, yung mga inquiries ninyo, dumiritso na lang kayo sa aming messenger sa Facebook para masagot namin agad. Ayos pa? Ayos na ayos niya, Mr. Maravilla.
Take a look at what happened.
Sigawan sila. Kinover si Trump ng mga US secret agents. Kaya si Trump, bumabangon siya, kinukover. Wait, let me get my shoes, sabi niya. Natanggal siguro yung sapatos niya. Tapos, ayan, tinakbo papuntang sasakyan niya po, mga kababayan. Kinover na siya ng mga supporters niya.
Habang papasok sa sa sasakyan, mga kababayan. Tapos, binakbaka na din pala ng mga US secret agents. Binaril na rin pala, mga kababayan, yung alleged shooter.
So, sabi dito sa balita, right away, si President Joe Biden brinip na rin po on the incident. Sabi po ng White House, he received an updated briefing from Kimberly Chittle, the Director of the United States Secretary Service, Homeland Security, Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas, saka po kay White House Homeland Security Advisor Liz Sherwood Randall. Then yung eldest son ni Donald Trump Jr., nag-post po sa X, ng image ni Trump ng kanyang tatay, his fist raised in his face bloody in front of an American flag with the words, "Hell never stop fighting to save America." So he will never stop fighting to save America.
Sabi po sa post ng kanyang anak, si Trump Jr.
North Dakota Governor Doug Burgum, Florida Senator Marco Rubio, and Ohio Senator J.D. Vance, the three men on Trump's shortlist for vice president, lahat mabilis na nagpalabas ng statement expressing concern for the former president. Si Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro, na isang Democrat po, kapartido ni Biden, said in statement on X that he had been briefed on the situation and Pennsylvania State Police were on hand at the rally site. Sabi niya, violence targeted at any political party or political leader is absolutely unacceptable niya. It has no place in Pennsylvania or the United States.
Sabi po ng gobernador. O ngayon, si Joe Biden, President Joe Biden, mga kababayan, nagpaabot na rin po ng kanyang statement.
Ito po as published by Manila Bulletin. Pakinggan po natin.
I've been thoroughly briefed by all the agencies in this situation.
Ito po siya, ulitin natin.
I've been thoroughly briefed by all the agencies in the federal government as to the situation based on what we know now. I have tried to get a hold of Donald. He's with his doctors. Apparently he's doing well. I plan on talking to them shortly, I hope, when I get back to the telephone. Look, there's no place in America for this kind of violence. It's sick. It's sick. It's one of the reasons why we have to unite this country. We cannot allow for this to be happening. We cannot be like this. We cannot condone this. And I want to thank the Secret Service and all the agencies, including the state agencies, that have been engaged in making sure that the people who, and we have more detail to come relative to other people maybe injured in the audience. I don't have all that detail. Relative to other people maybe in the audience. I don't have all that detail. We'll make that available to you. I may be able to come back a little later tonight, but we'll put out a statement if it's not convenient for you all. But the bottom line is that the Trump rally was a rally that he should have been able to be conducted peacefully without any problem. But the idea that there's political violence or violence in America like this is just unheard of. It's just not appropriate. And everybody must condemn it. Everybody. I'll keep you informed, and if I am able to speak to Donald, I'll let you know that as well. But so far, it appears he's doing well, number one. Number two, that they're thoroughly investigating what happened to anyone else in the audience. We have some reports, but not final reports. And every agency in the federal government, I'm going back to my phone to speak with the federal agencies that are being put together again to give me an updated briefing. Has anything happened? They learned any more in the last couple hours. So thank you very much, and I hope I get to speak to them tonight, and I'll get back to you if I do, okay? I don't know enough to... I have an opinion, but I don't have any facts. So I want to make sure we have all the facts before I make any more comments. Thank you.
So, tungkol kung sino po ang nasa likod nito, I have my opinion na yan, sabi ni President Joe Biden, but I don't have any facts. Kaya, magbibigay na lang po sila ng update. Siyempre, magsasagawa muna siyempre ng mga pasusing investigasyon yung mga authorities sa Amerika. Kung ano yung motibo, kung sino yung posible na nasa likod po o utak, wala pang idea yung mga authorities po sa Amerika.
So sabi dito, political leaders on both sides of the aisles slammed the attack minutes after the Republican candidate was rushed off stage by the Secret Service with blood running down his face.
So lahat, both Republican and Democrat politicians po, kinundi na itong assassination attempt kay Donald Trump.
Sabi po ni President Joe Biden, there's no place in America for this kind of violence, anya. It's sick. It's sick. It's one of the reasons why we have to unite, anya, this country. The idea that there's political violence or violence in America like this is just unheard of. It's just not appropriate. Everybody must condemn it. Everybody, sabi po ni President Biden. Si Vice President Kamala Harris po, nag-post naman po sa X. Sabi niya, we are praying for him, his family, and all those who have been injured and impacted by this senseless shooting. Biden, former boss Barack Obama, Biden's former boss Barack Obama, echoed his words in a statement saying, there was absolutely no place for political violence in our democracy. Although, Anya, we don't yet know exactly what happened, we should all be relieved that former President Trump was not seriously hurt and use this moment to recommit ourselves to civility and respect in our politics. Sabi naman po ni dating President George W. Bush, kinundi na po niya ang attack kay Trump at tinawag niya na cowardly attack. Sabi po niya, Laura and I are grateful that President Trump is safe following the cowardly attack on his life. And we commend the men and women of the Secret Service for their speedy response. From the Senate naman po, top Democrat Chuck Schumer said he was horrified by what happened at Trump rally. Political violence anya has no place in our country. Sabi naman po ni Republican counterpart Mitch McConnell, tonight anya all Americans are grateful that President Trump appears to be fine after a despicable attack on a peaceful rally. Violence has no place anya in our politics. The House Speaker Nancy Pelosi naman po nagsabi, as one whose family has been the victim of political violence, I know firsthand that political violence of any kind has no place in our society, anya. Sabi ni dating Speaker Nancy Pelosi, whose husband was attacked in a home invasion in 2022. I thank God, anya, that former President Trump is safe. As we learn more details about this horrifying incident, let us pray that all those in attendance at the former President's rally today are unharmed. Yung mga anak naman po ni Trump na nasyak sa nangyari sa kanilang tatay, also talk to social media. This is the fighter America needs, sabi po nila. Son Eric Trump wrote above a photo of his father with blood running down his cheek, his fist in the air, in an American flag waving in the background as the Secret Service rushed him from the stage. Donald Trump Jr. posted the same photo, writing on X, he'll never stop fighting to save America. I love you, Dad, today and always. Daughter Ivanka posted on X, thanking supporters as well as Secret Service for their quick and decisive action today. I continue to pray for our country, sabi po niya. Si tech billionaire Elon Musk said Saturday that he fully endorses Trump after the rally violence. I fully endorse President Trump and I hope for his rapid recovery, Musk wrote on X as he shared a video of Trump pumping his fist while being escorted away by Secret Service officials. Sabi naman po ni Texas Governor Greg Abbott, had it been less than a half inch to the right, he would not have survived. Sabi po ng Republican Governor, Trump is truly blessed, sabi po niya.
Ngayon, yung ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos, nag-react na rin po.
O yan po yung post niya sa X. Sabi dito sa report ng Philippine Star 36 minutes ago, we condemn all forms of political violence. President Bongbong Marcos offers his thoughts and prayers to former U.S. President Donald Trump after the latter was shot during a rally in Butler, Pennsylvania. Ito po yung sabi ng ating Pangulong Bongbong. It is with great relief that we receive the news that former President Donald Trump is fine and well after the attempt to assassinate him. Our thoughts and prayers are with him and his family. Together with all democracy-loving peoples around the world, we condemn all forms of political violence. The voice of the people must always remain supreme.
So, ano-anya Mr. Marabillas ang masasabi mo dyan? Nakakalungkot po. At yun nga po, mga kababayan, kaya siguro dito sa atin, hindi Hindi naging maganda yung naging reactions ng mga kababayan natin, lalo yung mga congressmen, doon sa naging statement po ni Inday na I am appointing myself as a designated survivor, na parang may nalalaman na pagbabanta sa buhay ng ating Pangulong Bongbong at mga officials ng ating gobyerno.
Yun ang naging dating sa karamihan, mga kababayan.
Sabi ng mga congressmen, that is inappropriate. It is reckless. Para bang may pag-wi-wish. Yung iba naman, ang reading nila, mga kababayan, parang veiled threat yung binitawan ng mga salita ni Inday. Ang latest ngayon po na nagpalabas ng condemnation, si Risa Ontiveros.
Iyan po yung balita ngayon sa Impact Leadership. Oh. Napaka-irresponsable, reckless statement. Yung ginawa ni Inday na sabi, joke man lang daw yun. Yun ang reading ng iba.
Pero si Inday, hindi man niya sinabi na joke man lang niya yun. Di ba?
So sabi po ni Risa Ontiveros, napaka-irresponsable, reckless statement. Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Ontiveros criticizes Vice President Sara Duterte's designated survivor remark after Duterte confirmed she would not attend President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. III SONA State of the Nation Address or SONA. Sa interview po ng DWIC kahapon, sinabi ni Ontiveros, she expressed concern over the implications of Duterte's statement. She questioned its potential threats and emphasized Duterte's responsibility to set a respectful example for her government colleagues. Ontiveros described the remark as reckless and irresponsible coming from one of the country's highest ranking officials, especially given the significance of the zona. Empon, sabi niya, napaka-irresponsable niya. Reckless statement ng isang pangalawang pinakamataas na opisyal ng ating bansa na dapat nagbibigay ng magandang halimbawa ng respeto sa kapwa na katrabaho niya sa gobyerno at respeto sa isa sa pinakamalagang gawain ng Kongreso taon-taon. Kita ninyo, mga kababayan?
Kung isipin po, si Risa Ontiveros Dilawan, kritik ng ating Pangulong Bongbong Marcos. Pero si Inday po, kayo ni Tim, nang humiwalay, ganito na po, mga kababayan, yung kanyang mga pinagsasabi. Irresponsible and reckless, mga kababayan. At sabi ng iba, it's a veiled threat niya na pinalalabas, parang lumalabas. Talagang si Inday po at ang kampo niya, atat na pumalit sa ating Pangulong Bongbong. Di ba po?
Ayan man lang po ang ating short video ngayon. Ako po si Dante Maravillas. Bye-bye. God bless.